Hello friends, in this session we are going to talk about time and work. We'll first discuss the concept related to time and work, and then we will see how do we solve questions related to this topic. So now let's look at the concept related to time and work. Now this basically talks about, say for example, we have two persons. One person can do a certain task in say 5 days, and let's name this person A, and we have another person B who can finish the same task say in 3 days. So now if we have this kind of information given to us, and if we want to have both A and B working together on the same task, then we can find out how much time would be required to finish the work. Or if in certain arrangement A can say for example work only for 1 day or 2 days, then we know that for how many days would we want B to work on the task to be able to finish it. So these are the different scenarios that may occur when, and we're just talking about two people, we could have more than two people. Say we have 5 people working on it and everybody has their own efficiency. So we can find out, we can work out a way in which the task can be completed, and we can have different people working for different durations. And this could also be, this concept could also be used when we want to find out how many more resources are required to finish the task earlier than it is possible now in the current scenario. So this concept of calculating the details like that is the time and work concept. Now we'll take an example. Say A complete a task in X days while B finishes the same task in Y days. Now how many days will they take to finish the task if they work on it together? Now when we say together, we are saying both of them are continuously working on it. But then there could be other things that, you know, A works on it partly and then B starts after A has done half of the work, or things of that nature. So we could have different questions, different scenarios which could be sorted out using this concept. So now let's see, where do we use this concept? It's very, very useful in planning different tasks and their timely completion. So when a few people are working on a task, this concept can be used to calculate their salaries depending upon the amount of work done by each. Now supposing A and B, we are taking two people only, are working on the same task, and A also works on it for 1 day, B also works on it for 1 day, but A finishes only 1/4 of the work in that 1 day, and B is highly efficient and B completes 3/4 of the work in the same day. Now, would it be fair if we pay them equal salaries just because both of them worked for one complete day? Probably not. So that is where, you know, we'll try to find out how much of work is done by each of them and then pay them accordingly. So this concept is used to calculate their salaries depending upon the work that they've done. If we have to finish a task in fixed amount of time, we can find out how many more people will be needed to complete the task. Now supposing we have 5 people already working on the task, and we know that it's a big task, it'll take 1 month to complete. Now if I want to finish the task in say half the time, which is 15 days, how many more people should I add to the work so that I can finish it early? Now in that case, I will have to find out people with the same efficiency as these 5. So based on that, I can find out how many more people can I add to the task so that the task can be completed in half the time. If certain people have to leave in the middle of the task, or some person need to be added in the middle of the task, this concept will help in working out the detailed plan. What is the detailed plan? Say for example, in the above example that we took, 5 people have already worked on the task for 15 days. For 10 days, say. Now I know that I need to add more people after 10 days so that I can still finish it in 15 days. So how many more people do I add for these 5 days so that the task can be completed? Now this can be, these details can be worked out based using the concept of time and work. Now supposing we have some adults working on a task and children working on it, or some, you know, different efficiency people are working on it, or maybe we have machines to, you know, we have different machines which are used to complete a task, but the machines have different efficiency levels. So based on that, we can also find out how many resources or which type, or if you're talking about machine, which machine to be used for how much time, so that we can complete the task in the required time, and if we have constraint of money, then within the required budget we can complete it. So those kind of details can be worked out here. And then there could be other cases. Now here we've just talked about the work that is being done by a few people or probably machine. Now there could be other uses of this concept. Say for example, we have a tank where we have taps to fill in the tank, and there are a couple of taps or maybe one tap at the bottom of the tank which is emptying it also. So now we can find out how many taps, which type of taps would be running for how long to be able to probably completely empty the tank or fill the tank. So those are the different, that's just to give a flavor of the different type of questions or different type of real life problems where the time and work concept can be used. And all of these that we talked about are real life problems. We know that we have to get certain work done in a required budget, in a required amount of time. So we need to find out, we need to work out all the details around it, which, where we use this concept. Now let's look at the basics of this, of time and work concept. Let A finish a task in 2 days and B finish the same task in 5 days. So now when we are saying A finishes it in 2 days, we are saying A working alone finishes in 2 days. B finishes the same task working alone in 5 days. Let's see how many days will it take to finish the task if both work together. Should we simply add or subtract the days that A takes and B takes to get the result? Now supposing we add the two and we get 2 plus 5, 7 days, and we say it'll take 7 days to finish the task. Is that the right approach? Of course not, because in 2 days A is already finishing the task. In 5 days B is already finishing the task. If you're talking about 7 days both of them working together, that does not add up, because we are giving more time than both of them working together to finish the task, which does not make sense. Similarly, if you simply subtract it and if you say 5 minus 2, so A and B working together will take 3 days to finish the task. That also does not add up, because A alone is able to finish it in 2 days. Why would A and B working together take 3 days to finish it? So adding or subtracting this data directly is not going to give you the result. So what is wrong in this approach? We've just talked about it. Because now we are adding more people to work on it, the task has to be finished earlier. So this concept of simply adding or subtracting is not working here. So we need to use the logic. How do we calculate? Now the first thing that we have to do is, how much of the task can be finished in 1 day by A alone and by B alone. So we say that if A is finishing a task in 2 days and B is finishing a task in 5 days, how much of the task, we are not talking about the number of days now, we are just talking about how much of the task would be completed by A in one day? And similarly, how much of the task would be completed by B in one day? So we are saying A completes half the task in one day, because A is taking 2 days to complete the task. So that means in one day, A will be able to complete half the task. Similarly, B would be able to complete 1/5 of the task in one day, because it's taking B 5 days to be able to finish the task. So in one day, B can only do 1/5 of it. Now, to find out if both of them are working together, how much of the task would be done in one day, we can simply add it together. So we can say if A and B work together, so 1/2 plus 1/5 task would be done in one day, which gives us 7/10. 7/10 of the task would be done in one day. So now, seeing that in one day we are able to finish 7/10 of the task, the complete task would be done in 10/7 days. Right? So this is looking at the numbers that we had, 2 and 5. We clearly see that it is not a simple addition, it is not a simple subtraction, but we have to use a different logic. We have to find out how much of the task is done in one day by each of them and then add them together. So friends, now let's take a look at the step-by-step approach to time and work problems. The first thing to be done in time and work related questions is to find out the work done by each person, group or resource per unit time. So in the previous example, we took per day, but it is actually going to be per unit time, because the unit of the time in some cases could be hours, could be days, could be seconds, or could be any other unit. So we need to find out the work done by each person, group or resource. So the right word to be used would be resource. It could be a person, it could be a group, it could be a machine, it could be a tap, it could be anything else. So we have to find out the work done by each resource per unit time. All the operations like adding or subtracting should be performed on this. Now, why would we need to subtract is the question. We were in the previous example, we just said that A did half the work in one day, B did 1/5 of the work in one day, and we add them together when both of them are working together. Now, why would we need to subtract it? We would see this with the help of a few examples, but just to give an idea here, now supposing we are filling a tank and two taps are open to which are filling the tank continuously, and one tap is open which is emptying the tank simultaneously. So now in that case, the tap which is emptying the tank, for that the operation to be performed would be subtracted from the work which the other two taps are doing by filling the tank. So this is where we'll have different operations like addition and subtraction to be performed. Now find out the final time taken to complete the work or the other things which need to be calculated. Like we said that we may probably have to find out how many resources do we need to add to be able to finish a task early. So whatever details we want to find out depending upon the problem at hand, we can find that out by using these first two steps. Now let's move on to an example where we'll get more clarity on how to use this concept to solve the problems. If Rohan can finish a work in 10 days and Sohan in 20 days, how many days will they take to complete the work together? We've already done a similar question where A took 2 days and B took 5 days to finish it. Now let's see another example for the same. Rohan's 1 day work is 1/10. Sohan's 1 day work is 1/20. So the total work done in 1 day by Rohan and Sohan is 1/10 plus 1/20, which adds up to 3/20. So that would mean that they will take 20/3 days, which comes out to be 6 2/3 days to complete the work if they're working together on it. Moving on to the second example, A and B can do a piece of work in 10 and 12 days respectively. They worked alternately for 10 days and then B left the work. Now this is a complicated situation. This is not a straightforward situation where both of them are working together or only one person is working. We are saying, first of all, they're working alternately for 10 days and then B left the work. In how many days will the work be completed if A continues the work till completion? Now A's 1 day work is 1/10, B's 1 day work is 1/12. So work done in 2 days will be, A works on the first day and B works on the second day, or B works on the first day and A works on the second day, because they're working alternately. Both of them are not working simultaneously. Both of them are not working together. So in 2 days, we'll get 1/10 plus 1/12, which is 11/60 work would be done in 2 days. Now for 10 days, this process continues. So work done in 10 days would be, we'll multiply this by 5. So 11/12 work is already done in 10 days when B leaves the work. Now work remaining is 1/12. So time taken by A to complete 1/12 of the work would be 10/12, which is 5/6 days, a little less than a day. So this is the time. In how many days will the work be completed? Total time taken to complete the work would be 10 days plus 5/6 days. So 10 5/6 days is the total time which will be taken to complete the work in this fashion. Moving on to the third example, if Ram and Shyam can finish a work in 8 days, we are saying now both of them working together, they finish the work in 8 days. We have Shyam and Mohan working together and they finish the work in 12 days. And then we have Ram and Mohan working together and they can finish the work in 16 days. Now, if we have all of them working together for 2 days, how many more days will Ram need to finish the remaining work? Now, we have for 2 days, we put all of them, all three of them to work. And then after that, we only have Ram to finish the work. So we need to find out how many more days would Ram need to finish the remaining work. So Ram and Shyam's 1 day work is 1/8. Ram and Mohan's 1 day work is 1/12. And Ram and Mohan's 1 day work is 1/16. So if we add them together, we can say twice of everybody's 1 day work would be 1/8 plus 1/12 plus 1/16. Why twice? Because if everybody's work is added twice, Ram has worked 2 times, Shyam is again coming 2 times, and Mohan is again 2 times. So we are saying twice of everybody's 1 day work is 1/8 plus 1/12 plus 1/16. So this adds up to 13/48. So in 1 day, twice of everybody's work would be 13/48. So everybody's 1 day work is 13/96, because this is twice the work, so we'll divide it by 2. So we get 13/96, and all of them now working for 2 days, again multiply by 2. So we can say again 13/48 is their 2 days work. Now, how much of the work is remaining? This is 1. 1 is the complete work is 1 minus 13 by 48, which is 35 by 48. So, this is the work which is remaining. Now, Ram's one day work is 13 by 96 minus 1 by 12, which is equal to 5 by 96. Why are we saying that? Because we know that, let me take a different color. We are saying everybody's one day work is 13 by 96. Now we need to find out Ram's one day work, which would mean out of this everybody's one day work, we'll have to subtract Shyam and Mohan's one day work, which is this 1 by 12. So we subtract 1 by 12 from 13 by 96 and we get 5 by 96. This is the work that Ram does in one day. So Ram completes one work, the complete work in 96 by 5 days, but he has to finish 35 by 48 work. So the time taken for that would be 96 by 5 into 35 by 48. So we get this 5 sevens are and 48 twos are 96. So we get 14 days. So Ram would need 14 more days to finish the remaining work. Moving on to the next example. Now here we take up the questions on that we talked about pipes or tanks tank being filled by pipes or the taps. So a pipe can fill a tank in 5 hours, and another pipe can empty it in 6 hours. How many hours will they take to fill it if both of them are working together? So that means a tank is being filled by one pipe and it is being emptied by another pipe simultaneously. So how many hours will it take to fill this tank? First pipe's 1 hour work is 1 by 5. Second pipe's 1 hour work is 1 by 6. So in 1 hour, now here we'll need to do a subtraction. Why? Because 1 by 5th of the tank is filled in 1 hour, whereby 1 by 6th of the tank is emptied in 1 hour. So the net resultant of how much tank would be filled in 1 hour would be 1 by 5 minus 1 by 6, which is 1 by 30. So it will take, in 1 hour, only 1 30th of the tank is filled. So both the pipe will take 30 hours. If 1 30th of the tank is filled in 1 hour, it will take 30 hours to fill the whole tank. Moving on to the last example on this, we have two pipes which can fill a cistern in 24 minutes and 32 minutes respectively. Now we are saying one pipe working at one time fills it in 24 minutes, the other pipe working alone again fills it in 32 minutes. If both the pipes are opened together, and after how much time should second pipe be closed such that the cistern is full in 18 minutes? So we know for sure that the cistern takes 18 minutes to fill it, and in the beginning we've opened both the pipes, and after some time the second pipe is closed such that the cistern takes 18 minutes to fill. Now let second pipe be closed after X minutes. So for 18 minus X minutes, only the first pipe is working. Why? After X minutes. So total time is 18 minutes. So here to here we have 18 minutes. After this X minutes, for these X minutes we have both pipe opened, and here this is 18 minus X. Here only the first pipe is working. Right? So for 18 minus X minutes, we have only first pipe working. For X minutes, both the pipes are working. First pipe fills water in 1 minute is 1 by 24. So we said we'll have to find per unit time, which is minute in this case. So per minute, the first pipe is able to fill 1 by 24 of the system. Second pipe does fills 1 by 32 of the system in 1 minute. So both pipes fill adding them together, we get 7 by 96 of the system in 1 minute. And both of them are working for x minutes. So in x minutes, they'll have 7x by 96 of the cistern would be filled in the x minute when both the pipes are opened. In 18 minus x minutes, only the first pipe is working, and that will fill 18 minus x by 24, because 1 by 24 in 1 minute. So 18 by minus x divided by 24 in 18 minus x minutes. So we know this is the tank which is filled in x minutes. This is the tank which is filled in the remaining 18 minus x minutes. And the net result is after 18 minutes, the cistern is not the tank, the cistern is full. So total tank is filled, which means 7x by 96 plus 18 minus x by 24 is equal to 1. So that gives us 7 by 96x plus 4 into 18 minus x by 96 is equal to 1. And we solve it, we get 3x is equal to 96 minus 72, which is 24. So x is equal to 8 minutes. So we are saying after 8 minutes. So the question was, after how much time should the second pipe be closed? So we should close it after 8 minutes, so that the total time taken to fill the cistern would be 18 minutes. So these are the different, this is just a flavor of some of the questions related to time and work. There could be other things that we need to find out, but the concept remains the same, that we first need to find out the work done per unit time, and then we should perform an addition or subtraction operation on that, and then work on it to find out the remaining details.
Friends, I hope you enjoyed the session. If you find it useful, please like it and share it with your friends. You can visit us at our Cool Smart Learning website and post your queries there. And please subscribe to the Cool Smart Learning channel for getting updates on the new sessions. Thank you.